Destiny 2. I haven't even, logged into the game yet. So, I thought, kind of similar to my Breath of the Wild, I'd be like, okay, this is the first time I'm going to log in. I'm going to record this, do this. For those of you who don't know, I'm a big Destiny 1 fan. Still got it installed over here. Destiny 2 with great anticipation. Hopefully it's going to be good, but we'll have to wait and see. But let's not hang around. It's about 2 a.m. in the morning here in the UK. It came out at midnight. And I've just got home from work. Now, admittedly, I have done the first mission before because it was in the beta. Licensing stuff, eh? Yeah, I have done the beta because it was in the. I'd have done the first mission because it was in the beta, I was going to say. But I'm looking forward to just taking my time and just soaking in Destiny 2 and enjoying it. I didn't have a channel at the time Destiny 1 came out because YouTube didn't exist then. That's a joke. Let's do it a little bit brighter because YouTube subtitled, we want enabled, is please. So I'm looking forward to kind of going from day one in Destiny 2 to I don't know when, who knows when, maybe just day 7, but maybe day 900 and something, who knows right now.
I never knew you.
Maybe turn up the
You died on a battlefield long before my time. Something special brought us together. They called it the Traveler. And when it arrived, it changed your world forever. It was a golden age. And for centuries, humanity thrived. Until it didn't. An ancient enemy pursued the Traveler across the universe. Humanity faced extinction. But the Traveler made a choice. Its sacrifice destroyed its ancient enemy and brought life to the ghosts. I am a ghost. More importantly, I'm your ghost. And you are one of the Traveler's chosen. You are a guardian. This is your destiny.
This is my destiny. Of Iron, we answered Saladin's call and became Iron Lords. 8th of 10th, 2016. Oh, I love this already. Start a new adventure. Oh my god, I'm so excited. I literally had, moments earlier in the day where work, and I had that, like, almost like kind of like that, those butterflies in the stomach where you're just like, oh my god, this is happening. Okay, so I think these are probably from my these are my characters from Destiny 1. Oh cool. I had a warlock and a hunter. I never made a titan.
If you tell me this is a practical joke, well, it kills me to say it, but I would be really impressed.
Impressing you, Cade, is the easiest thing I'll do all day.
Let's get serious, people.
Zavala, this is my serious face. Can't you tell?
Ikora, what have you got?
Someone or something has sabotaged the Skyline defense systems.
And comms have been spotty for the last few hours. Every sensor beyond the wall has gone dark.
Maybe it's just the storm. Maybe it's... What are the set feeds telling us?
Nothing.
Well, that's good, right?
No. I mean, they're not there. There are no satellites.
And that's not good.
Battle stations! Everyone with me, now!
This is such a cool moment. So crazy. Is that the ghost shell I had from Destiny 1 as well? I never noticed that till just then. That is so cool if that's the case. I can't remember exactly, but it might be. That's a nice touch if it is.
find Zabala, Ikora, and Cade.
It looks good as well. It does look really good. I am playing this on PlayStation 4 Pro, but not on a 4K TV or anything. It's actually a 2K monitor. It still looks good. Played it on PC on the beta as well, and honestly was not that impressed, so I thought I'd stick it to PlayStation 4. I happen to know that some guys are going to come through there and can I access it? See the kind of like robotic people hanging around, but we never quite you never see these little bits behind the scenes and stuff like that, which is really cool. This obviously is the main hall. Yeah, it's the main hall, isn't it? I believe. Is this bit the main hall, or is there another bit that's the main hall? I think I'm getting confused now. One of the bits is. Man, this does look really good. Destiny 1 looks so good though for its era. See you later, sucker. Can't get through there, no. Okay. So, this does feel slightly changed from the beta, which is good. I think they said they were
going to do that. Hey, you two, give me a sec.
Nice.
Zavala's doing the hero thing in the plaza. Me?
I love his gun as well.
I'm going to date with whoever's behind this. It'll be a short date.
It's an exotic you can get, but I never had it, unfortunately. It's got the Ace of Spades. Some Seros stuff over there. Asura's regime being one of my favourite weapons from the first Destiny, and I love these effects as well. It's so good. Yeah, these effects are really good. We'll see it a bit more when we go outside as well. I love the weather effects and how they look. Got anything over here? Oh god. Oh, this reminds me of Trespasser. Which is not a bad thing, because I actually really liked that exotic. Maybe I was the only person who did. Reminds me a lot of the Taken King, that ship that crashes into the Dreadnought. It's pretty cool, and this is a bit we rarely ever get to see as well in Destiny's The Hangar.
I don't want to be around when Amanda sees what happened to her tools.
Of course, yeah, this is where the quartermaster was. Where you could buy weapons and things. And then this was where Amanda was, just up here. Amanda Holiday, who dealt with the ships and things like that. And the, God, I actually forgot the name of them now. The little bike things. I've actually forgotten the name. And then there would be Dead Orbit would be here. And I'm saying this like Destiny 1 is this really ancient thing, but in reality, I could have just played it yesterday, you know. I didn't, but you know, was wondering if there was a way to get up to the top there. Doesn't look like it. So this area we're fairly familiar with. We would run around here, then off to the right, up here.
Okay, my ghost keeps tagging these cabal as Red Legion. Agora, what do you got?
They're elite, ruthless, and rumor is they have never known defeat.
Until today. Today they face Guardians.
But Zavala, they're attacking the Traveler.
The Traveler waits. We protect our people at any cost.
The Traveler? What is that thing they're attaching to it?
Social area of the tower, which frankly is not looking too social right now.
This line until the last civilian is safely away.
Incoming! Fall back to my team!
I swear you have to get underneath his shield, or else you will,
Don't let them pass the gate! The evac shuttles are back there!
That's the gunsmith. So strange not to have like a right, an R1, like whatever.
We hold here. That command ship, it's next on my list.
Okay.
Pistol, stay inside my shield.
I'm staying in your shield, buddy. Don't worry.
More Red Legion. Show them what Guardians are made of.
So Zavala here, if you haven't played Destiny 1, you don't know who he is basically the leader of the Guardians, he's the vanguard of the Titans, basically, and it's kind of thought of, I guess, it's like the tactical, like, you know, the leader, I guess, of all of the vanguard. He doesn't get involved too much in things in Destiny 1. Leaves that up to Ikora and Cade, who are the other two. We've seen Cade already. He was the Pixel guy with the golden gun.
Zavala,
he's the leader of the Hunters.
But the speaker, he never made it. I'm going to look for him.
I've got the plaza. Go with Ikora. Find the speaker.
We're on
okay.
It, Commander.
I mean, you say you've got the plaza, but you haven't flipping done anything yet, have you? You've got your free guns around. Jesus Christ, he landed on top of me. That was not good.
Keep moving, gotta keep going.
So I jump off that onto the top of this. Because you could never double jump in the area, so it was never that easy to just jump on top of there. And that used to be where Eris originally was. She was here originally, but she moved. That was the Dark Blow, the first expansion, which wasn't the greatest expansion. always was constantly throughout all of Destiny 1. Bless him. You have a good time, buddy. Which way are we going? This way. Yeah. And Korra comes in and overbombs. Is the leader of the warlocks. She's thought of as, I guess, the intelligent, you know, the smart one. She's also pretty badass in the Crucible as well. Apparently she holds records in the Crucible, which is the PvP stuff. As well, I believe, from the lore. Let's try and look around here, see if Zer's here. Hey there, Holiday. This is Amanda Holiday. And this is a cutscene coming up.
Zavala, picked up that guardian you never showed up about?
Get them on that command ship, now!
This is kind of also bits we hardly ever see in Destiny as well, the actual flying of ships.
Come on, big guy. Do something. All right, Guardian. Time to kick him where it hurts.
Effects just coming up as well. It looks so good. So pretty much after this mission, everything will be blind for me. I love the way the rain is down, we'll hit that coming ship with sideways. Okay. The Immortal. Is that what it's called? The Immortal. It's called the name of the ship. That's a good name for a ship. Mission. is, as I said, the leader of the Hunters. Bit of a loose cannon, and probably everybody's favourite character from Destiny 1. With good reason. Mostly because it's Nathan Fillion who voices him, and he's really, really good. Shots obviously do more damage in Destiny as it does any other game. Some done. I feel way more powerful than I did in the beta, that's for sure. Also, in the beta, I had like loads of different weapons by this point. So. I like this pistol. Oh god. Oh shit, where's he gone? There we go. The old golden gun doing the business once more.
Turbines. The shield should fizzle.
Oh.
Shields are down. Zavala?
Guardian, something's wrong.
Do not look at me, creature.
That is gonna
happen. You are weak, undisciplined, cowering behind walls. You're not brave. You've merely forgotten the fear of death. Allow me to reacquaint you. Your kind never deserved the power you were given. I am Gorm. And your light is mine.
Did it actually disconnect? That's hilarious. That is actually hilarious if that did just happen. Oh boy. I wonder if that's like a TV problem or if my internet literally just shut down. Internet might have just collapsed actually. Well, that's good. Let's just give it a moment, see if it just jumps back in. I think my internet's been really slow recently actually. Might have to make another phone call or write a strongly worded letter of some sort. But if not, we can finish up here then. Next episode, I'll just start recording from that point because, yeah, I'm not sure if it will actually jump in, but, well, you know, always have these little teething problems, don't we, anyway? Thanks for watching, as always, it's been my pleasure, I guess, and we'll jump back in, hopefully, just where we left off next episode. Till then, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.